Hello everyone, so welcome to my channel Happiness at Your Fingertips, and today I'm going to introduce you to my fine cake colors. So this is from Amazon and I'll provide you the link in the description box below. So before that, I'm going to show you what and how we are painting today. So this is the masking tape that I have put to my paper, and yeah, I want to show you the colors that I have got. I'm super excited to use this. So have a look, isn't it lovely? So many colors in a box, and I'm really excited. So let's get started now. Oh yeah, there are two brushes with the set. This is one, and it's super fine brush. I really love it. So any children who wants to start, you know, their painting can use this particular set. It's really fine in texture. So here I have drawn atmospheric wildflowers. These are simply wildflowers that I have drawn out, and I'm going to show you how I color flowers. So some of my friends wanted to know that what I use for coloring flowers, and this is the PABIO masking fluid that I generally use for coloring flowers. So you just put this masking fluid before, you know, you start painting, and this is how I use it. I'm using a normal simple twig, you know, for putting on the fluid. Please do not use your brushes because it will damage the brush. Just dip the twig in the fluid and draw out your petals or the stem or the areas that you want to, you know, keep out of the colors right now. So this is the parts that I want to keep out from colors, and I am using the masking fluid for that. So this particular masking fluid you will get at any stationery shop, and I have got it from a stationery shop in Hyderabad itself, but then it is also available in Amazon, and you can get it from there too. Okay, so I am done with the flowers and the stems right now, all covered with the masking fluid and a few dots or buds, you can say. And this is how it looks. So now let the masking fluid dry, and then we'll start with our painting. So again, this is the PABIO masking fluid that I'm using for my painting. You can use it too. So here it's dried up, and now we'll start by dampening the paper. I'm just using normal water for dampening the entire paper. I'm coating it with water. And now these are the list of colors that I have put, and I'm using only those colors for the entire painting. So deep yellow, that's the yellow chrome, and cadmium yellow are the ones that I will use for the background right now. And there are a number of green shades, as you can see. There are light green, there are dark green. So here I will use some of the green shades for the entire painting. You can choose your own. And of course, the light green and the dark green are to be mixed beautifully, and it brings out a beautiful color, you know. So this is how it looks right now. Just drop in a few colors, overlapping one another. This is how it actually looks. Okay, so some dark green for the, you know, grass areas. So this is the dark green that I'm using from my set of colors. Now this is the green that I already have, and I'm adding a little bit of blue to it so that I can bring in a little more shade to the grasses. And this is the beautiful deep blue or the turquoise color that you can see. I'm adding it for the grasses right now. Okay, so some brown for the dark portions of the grasses to give it a beautiful shade. Some brown and blue mixed together. And see, this is how it looks. Okay, so the entire painting is dried now, and the masking fluid is also dried up, and now is the time to remove the masking fluid. So I'll show you a simple technique. This is the masking tape that I have, and a piece of masking tape I'm using for removing the masking fluid. So you just need to pull over the areas of the masking fluid, and it will come out very easily. Just do not scratch over the paper. Just pull it over like this and it will come out very easily. See, this is how it looks. And it's almost done. I'm done with removing the masking fluid, and this is how it looks. These are my flowers. And now for the flowers, I'm going to use a super fine brush. So this was in the box and I'm using it. And I will use the dark purple and the dark pink for my flowers mainly, and some amount of blue. So I'll show you how. So first you need to dampen the flower petals with some little bit of water so that whatever color you put in, it spreads out evenly and gently. So here I am dampening the petals with little water, and I'll use the dark purple first. That's the dark purple shade. and I'll use it for my flowers first. Okay, so this is how it looks. Okay, now I'm using the dark pink. This is the pink that I'm using. I'll gently touch over the petals. So this is very simple, you see. Coloring flowers is very simple and I really love flowers, so I'm quite fond of it. So my most of the paintings is, you know, right now related to flowers. And something I guess is flower is something that attracts, you know, every human being at some point of time. So even children love flowers. So it's better to start as a beginner with flowers because, you know, it gives happiness to you. It simply gives happiness to you. When a petal or a flower comes out successfully, then you really feel very happy about it. So that's how I think about it. So now I'm adding a little blue to the tip of the flower. Now this is the particular shade that I love the most, the blue, purple and the pink shade. It's really, really wonderful. And it's very eye soothing, I feel. I remember a flower morning glory and it had simply this particular color. It used to bloom in the mornings, early mornings, and I had it in my home in Durgapur. So it was like looking at the flowers was like, you know, total bliss. It's a sort of creeper we used to have in our house. And it's of course it's a seasonal flower, so it exactly had the same, you know, color combination, that is the blue, pink and the purple one. Okay, now the final tone of the grasses, I have used, you know, dark brown and dark green for bringing out this tone. And for the leaves now, I'll start with some dark green. Okay, so the final tone I'm putting to the flowers, a little bit of purple. So this is it, it's done, and now is the time to add, you know, my magic drops. Okay, so before that I'll add some more pink because, you know, the pink portion has almost faded. Now one more thing I wanted to say is these particular cake colors needs a few tones, you know, for painting, because these are very light in texture. They may be fine, but they are very light in texture. They are not like the tube colors. And the final touch, I'm adding a little bit of white drops to the entire painting. This is what I call the magic drops because it changes your entire look of the painting that you are making. So this is how it finally looks, and I'll remove the masking tape and then I'll show it to you. Okay, so this is my final picture of atmospheric wildflowers watercolor art, and I hope you guys have liked it. So if you guys have liked my video, then please like and subscribe to my channel, and please click the bell button beside subscribe and stay with me for some more videos. Thanks a lot for watching.